In October 2018, the Pacific Ocean brewed one of the most intense hurricanes ever recorded, and it hit one of the most remote places in the world. With so much force, it eliminated an entire island overnight. But this isn't the first time an island has vanished. It's part of a trend. So what's behind it? The island we're talking about is East Island, located about 890 kilometers northwest of Honolulu, Hawaii. It may not seem like much, only 11 acres, but it's part of one of the world's largest protected marine areas. The region was home to diversity rarely found anywhere else on Earth. It was a nesting ground for over 95% of the Hawaiian endangered green sea turtle population, and about 200 critically endangered monk seals visit the area each year. And considering there's only 1,400 of these monk seals left in the state, it's a big deal. East Island is now a mere 46-meter patch of sand, and scientists estimate about 95% of the islet is underwater. Scientists don't know if this critical habitat will bounce back anytime soon, and are very concerned since islands don't just disappear overnight, right? It takes years and years of erosion, but islands are disappearing faster and it's becoming more common. Scientists have observed entire islands swallowed whole from sea level rise in a matter of a few short years. From 2007 to 2014 alone, 6 low-lying islands in Micronesia vanished without a trace. Those were uninhabited, but as recently as 2017, people of the Carteret Islands of Papua New Guinea are leaving their island homes for higher ground. As they avoid the rising sea levels, they also face dying trees, scarcity of food, and fresh water. They aren't the only ones either. The Maldives, Fiji, Marshall Islands, Republic of Kiribati, and Torres Strait Islands are all being affected by rising sea levels. Island nations across the globe are facing those same obstacles because they're the most vulnerable to the results of climate change. But wait, East Island didn't disappear from sea level rise. That was the fault of Hurricane Malacca. There's a connection because sea level rise can actually make the consequence of hurricanes worse. Higher sea levels means stronger storm surges, which create higher floods of water that move further inland. Hurricane Malacca was actually one of 2 major tropical storm surges in the Pacific, one on each side of the ocean that reached Category 5 at the same time, meaning they were forming over 250 kilometer per hour winds. Not only is this intense, but it's highly unusual behavior. Hurricane Malacca was much further north than most hurricanes travel. Scientists speculate that's because the Pacific's waters are warming. You see, typically, hurricanes are near the equator because that's where warmer waters are. Tropical storms form when warm air rises from warm water, causing low air pressure underneath of it. Nearby higher air pressure will then push into the low air pressure, and that new air becomes warm and rises up. Nearby air will then come in and take the warm air's place as it rises. In the upper atmosphere, the warm air cools down and creates clouds. This becomes a swirling system of hot and cold air being fed by the ocean's heat and water evaporation. In theory, more energy is released into the storm when there's a larger temperature between the warm water and upper atmosphere. Although climate scientists debate and can't directly link storms to climate change, they all agree that warm waters also cause stronger storms. And let's face it, the Pacific Ocean is getting mighty toasty. It turns out that 2017 was a record-breaking year for ocean waters. But hurricanes are not just getting severe in some far-off distant place in the Pacific. We can see the intensity from the Atlantic as well. The recent North Carolina hurricane dropped over 75 centimeters of water on parts of North Carolina, and many areas were flooded and blocked off. As for East Island, we'll see how it fares. NOAA will monitor the island's progress to see how the animals respond to their habitat loss, and what they find will help them manage the species. Some monk seals can already be seen lifting themselves up on the small patch of land left behind. So yes, sea levels are rising, hurricanes are getting worse, and they're wiping places off the map. While we can't witness what's going on beyond our backyards, it's all happening right now, even if we can't see it. Islands may be disappearing, but you know what won't vanish? Your very own website with domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space, even .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. Want updates on the status of your Earth? Subscribe! And check out this video to hear what happens if global temperatures get too warm by just 2 degrees Celsius. It's a doozy. Also, the strongest hurricane ever recorded in history was Hurricane Patricia back in 2015, which reached up to 346 km per hour winds. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.